Now, with Karnataka elections around the corner, the city of Bengaluru holds a distinct position. Not because it has 20th seat, but because of a distinct voting pattern. A voter in Bengaluru is not swayed by political affiliations or caste equation, but is influenced on the ground of civic issues. We spoke with prominent personalities and activists from the city and begin by understanding what are the key issues that are actually plaguing the city.
Everyone is very familiar with Bangalore's woes.
Public transport is again another misery in terms of number of cars on the road.
I mean, you think of 20 million people, 20, 25 million people living in a city which has limited water resources and very, very poor infrastructure, especially in the peri-urban area. It will girdle, the poor infrastructure is girdling and suffocating.
The bureaucracy that we have, Orwellian sometimes, in the sense that how they take decisions which are contrary to what is in the best interest of the city.
Bilandur Lake has become a huge, huge visible public issue.
Metro is kind of late. Maybe we should have started 10 years back.
They took on the leadership when there were attacks against, you know, women in Bangalore. A lot of aggression against the minorities, both Christian and Muslim. And so the Congress has calmed that down and put that at bay.
Whether it was investment in the metro network, the tender short road network, whether it was about lake revival, whether it was waste management, whether it was connectivity, you know, we've seen big budgetary allocations. Now it remains to be seen whether it was just an electioneering budget or whether we are going to see this budget being translated on the ground.
If you see most of the politicians and their even manifesto currently is all focused on infrastructure development. Now it's not only, you know, building something, you have to manage something, you have to run that thing efficiently.
We made several requests to have a directly elected mayor, and then they found via media to have a minister in charge for Bangalore. I think that was the first signaling effect that they finally consider Bangalore as an important part of Karnataka.
Corruption plays bigger this thing, development of the road, infrastructure and well-being.
Typically the popular response is traffic, because you know you're stuck most of the time.
Politically we have never mattered in terms of whether they need to really invest in Bengaluru or not. And yet we account for 60% of Karnataka's GDP, almost 60% of taxes that Karnataka gathers.
Manifesto cannot be something which they just publish and then they forget about it. People are going to now, last 5 years, I think this is the change the city has seen.
We want it to be an issues-based election. There are enough that we are facing. We don't, a lot of people say that, hey, Bangalore problems are not the worst, right? But we don't want it to become the worst.
All three have been consistent in ensuring the city does not have a chance to restructure itself and respond to its core concerns through a ground-up strategy of making the city work.
The BJP government was really a disaster. It was a huge wasted opportunity. JDS government, I think Mr. Kumaraswamy himself is a very bold person, very decisive and can do a lot of things that are good for the city. But I think their party lacks leadership. Whereas the Congress, well, we would have liked them to be much more efficient than they have been. But they have at least listened to some of the voices of the citizens.
All successive governments have paid lip service to Bengaluru.